Hey guys, what's up? Happy New Year. Sorry I've been away for the last month or so. I just wanted to take a break from Lego and I really wasn't in the mood to record any videos. But now I'm back and I want to share with you today just some of the stuff that I've been doing in the last few weeks. First off, for the Black Friday week, I managed to snag a lot of sets for a good price. So you'll see here, first off, we have the Spring Lantern Festival. This one I got from Amazon during the Cyber Monday deal, and I got it for 30% off, which is really exciting. I will be saving this to build in the coming weeks as we get closer to Chinese New Year. The other sets I got, and these were all from Toys R Us, I had a 15% off friends and family coupon, and there's also a 15% off Lego discount. So I got these all for 30% off the retail price, which is pretty fantastic. Here we have the one of the Disney sets. This is Raya and the Heart Palace. I bought this because I really like the color scheme. I love the turquoise and the gold color combination. I think it's really beautiful. So I'm looking forward to building this, as well as another Raya set. This is the Boone's Boat. I've wanted this ever since it came out, but it was always, I thought it was a little bit pricey for the number of pieces they have, but I bought this because I'm in love with the actual boat itself. I think it's super cute. It's like a shrimp boat, and I like Boone. I think he's an awesome character. He reminds me of my nephew, which is why I bought this. And then the other set I got is a friend's set. This is the Magical Funfair roller coaster. I really like this. I saw the latest season of Lego Friends, and I really like the circus characters, Claire and Stella and Camilla. I bought it primarily for the mini dolls. So these are all the ones that are unopened. In terms of set that I've already built, I have here the Chamber of Secret. So I finally built this. I finally got this. This is my first Harry Potter Lego set, and it didn't disappoint. I had a lot of fun building this. I'll probably be doing a review video of this soon. And then finally, this is the Fab Five Loft. I really like the show Fab Five. I watch it a lot on Netflix, and I love all the characters, and I love how they all have their own kind of special personality. My favorite one is definitely Bobby. I think he's a little underrated, and the design that he does has always blown me away, just how much better he makes the people's living spaces are. So, and the last thing I want to share with you is my Frugal Lego build. I'm still doing my Frugal Lego, and this is the latest one I got. This is the what is it called? Heart Lake City Park Cafe. So these I built using my own pieces, and of course, as I get more sets, I'm finding Frugal Lego easier and easier because I already have the majority of pieces that I need to make it. The final thing I want to talk about is the new January 2022 releases. There were a lot of new sets that recently came out, and I'm not going to go through all of them because I think there's enough coverage on YouTube that you can easily find a more detailed kind of review video of the new sets. But personally, there's a couple of sets that I'm really look forward to, and I'll be keeping an eye on whether I get it now or wait till there's a sale to get it. Hey guys, it's me in the future. As I was reviewing my video from yesterday, I realized that my mic is really close to my hair, and then there's a lot of these like random ruffling sounds, and it keeps getting increasingly worse throughout the video. So I've decided to kind of re-record the section in better audio. But what I was going to show you are all the friends set that I'm interested in this January wave. Here I have the Canal Houseboat. I really like this set. I think it's very innovative. It's I don't think I know there's a party boat that friends had maybe last year, the year before, but I think the houseboat is more to like my calling. I also like the colors are not very frenzy color. It's very like I don't know, almost like the 70s style with the brown and the yellow and the orange. There's the treehouse, which I think is really nice. But the street food market is the one that I am having kind of my eyes set on. This one I really like because of the mini dolls. I really like Emma's new hairpiece. I think this is, is she a new character? I really like her new character. Her hairpiece is fantastic as well. And of course, how can you say no to like a taco truck and a ramen? I think this is a ramen shop or a sushi shop and a juice bar. So I definitely
I feel like I'm gonna end up buying this set. I guess I don't know when. Maybe I'll wait for it to go on sale before I purchase that. The beach glamping is another one that I really look forward to. You guys know I really like camping, so anything that's like nature and camping themed, I'm absolutely have my eye set on this. This one I'm gonna wait till it goes on sale. I like it, but not enough to pay full price for it. So that's pretty much it for the Friends Wave. I also want to talk about the Disney Wave because they did something different this year with the mini dolls, and they have them at, oh my gosh, a lot of them are already out of stock. I guess they're really popular. The Madrigal House I really like because I just saw Encanto last week and I thought the movie was really good. I really like the songs. So I wanted to get the new mini dolls in this like crystal dress style. I think this is new, and it's really nice. I really like this and I'm interested to see how it looks like in real life. And I guess you can like take out her dress and then put the top underneath. To protect it, which is, and then it becomes a dreidel. I don't know, it's kind of weird, but anyways, I am excited about these new mini dolls. The City of Lanterns, it's already out of stock. My gosh, I guess other people like it too. This one I really like because of the train here, the pig train. Look how cute this is. There's the chef pig and the little tram kind of goes around the city. I really like the Asian theming to it. And I don't think I've owned a single Monkey Kid set, so this will be my first Monkey set purchase. Okay, so with the Chinese New Year sets, there are two that's been released this year. You have the Lunar New Year Ice Festival and the New Lunar New Year Traditions. I'm torn between which one to get. My heart is leaning towards the New Year's tradition because I really like this particular minifigure. He's like the fortune, the god of fortune, and he's holding these like hot dog buns with the stud on top, which kind of looks like the gold bouillons that olden days Chinese people use. I think he is phenomenal, so I might get the set just to get his mini figure. But the other set that a lot of people really enjoy is the Ice Festival. This one I think is really cute. You have like the platypus. What is his name from Phineas and Ferb? Percy? Percy? He reminds me of Percy. And there's a scene where everybody's skating, which I think it's nice, but to me, this is not Lunar New Year because I live in Canada and I associate this with like Canadian winter more so than like a Lunar New Year festival. So I think I'm gonna go between the two. I'm gonna get the traditions ones with the six vignettes. That's pretty much sums up all the sets that I want to get this wave. I probably won't get up everything that I wanted to. I do try to limit my purchases to just one set a month. And then if I wanted any other set, then I'll do like a bricks and pieces order, or I'll do a Bricklink order, and then I'll do like my Frugal Lego. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'll see you guys soon. Happy New Year again. Bye.